hope it has been great, because my week has been great too. So I have a question for you guys. What is your favorite subject? Is it maths, English, or even Afrikaans? You know what? I hate all of those subjects. But I like going to school because I can see my friends and we can have a lot of fun and we can talk about a lot of things. And I also like to go to school because I can see my teachers. They're very nice. Very, very nice. So I just hope you guys enjoy the rest of this video. I hope you guys have a big smile. I hope we make you happy because you make me happy. Okay, so we're just gonna pray. Okay, now close your eyes. So Father God, I just want to thank you for the kids who are there on the screen. May you just give them, may this day just be the best day of their life. May you just bless them and be with them. And amen.
What's up, everybody? So we're gonna new song, and it's all about kindness, and we're gonna dance, sing, and have some fun. Let's do this!
Just the facts of me, you and me. We don't see anything identically.
Don't even think a thought like me. But you matter to me, definitely. It don't matter, cause you matter.
Kindness fits everybody. Everybody wants kindness. Kindness serves everybody. Everybody needs kindness. Kindness fits everybody. Everybody wants kindness. Kindness serves everybody. Everybody needs kindness. Do we always run and hide? Pick our sides. Say we tried irrationally. We scream and shout. Get it out. We keep our doubts indefinitely. But now I think it's time we walk across.
You don't look like me, don't act like me, don't even think a thought like me. But you matter to me, definitely. It don't matter, cause you matter.
Kindness fits everybody. Everybody wants kindness. Kindness serves everybody. Everybody needs kindness. Kindness fits everybody. Everybody wants kindness. Kindness serves everybody. Everybody needs kindness.
The world we want won't happen in our blindness. No, oh. I'll do my part and meet you here with kindness.
2, 3, 4.
You don't look like me, don't act like me, don't. Don't even think a thought like me, but you matter to me, definitely. It don't matter, cause you matter.
Kindness fits everybody. Everybody wants kindness. Kindness serves everybody. Everybody needs kindness. Kindness fits everybody. Everybody wants kindness. Kindness serves everybody. Everybody needs kindness.
One more round, since no one won that. round just to see maybe if we can get it in. And we play one more round just in case because I've got some hope for Chloe.
In the oven right there. Now let me tell you something. I make the best biscuits of all. The most delicious, most awesome biscuits. My biscuits, they have everything in them. They've got chocolate chips, they've got cranberries, they've got gummy bears, they've got jelly tots, and guess what? Even more chocolate. Yeah, I can't wait, it's gonna be so good. I can't wait to get my hands on those biscuits. They're just, oh, it's gonna be so, so good. So, we're all about baking for the next couple of weeks, and baking is so much fun because all the most delicious things are baked, aren't they? What kind of things do you like to bake? What kind of things would you like to bake? Things like cookies or cakes, chocolate cake, carrot cake. What about milk tarts or apple pies? Oh, I've got it. I know exactly what you're thinking of. What about chocolate brownies? Oh yes, come on, chocolate brownies for the win, all the way. Yum, there is so many cool things that you can bake. And you know what, All-Stars? My mom is the best baker in the whole world. She bakes the best things better than anybody else's mom in the whole world. My mom is the best baker. And when I was younger, I used to get so excited when I would see, like, she was coming with the bowl and the spoon, and I get excited when I saw the milk and the sugar and all the stuff coming out, because I knew that if all that stuff came out of the kitchen, I knew my mom was about to bake and something delicious was on the way, and I could be really excited about that. Have you guys ever baked something before, maybe for school or for a school project? Baking is delicious. Now, there is one problem, one little problem when it comes to baking. One small, kind of tiny, like little minute kind of thing, right? The waiting. Those biscuits are still gonna take a while. Like, I'll look. Yeah, they're still not ready. They're not ready at all. Okay, the waiting. Waiting is so hard, because when I see all those delicious brownies and those cakes and those milk tarts and my delicious biscuits, I want to eat them right now. I don't want to wait. I want to have them right now, like this very second, you know? But the thing is, I have to wait, and that's not so good, especially when it's a cake. Cakes take so long to make. They take like forever, you know? And then you gotta wait for the cake, and then you gotta wait for it to be like iced, and you wait for it to cool, and then you gotta wait for it to get decorated, and then only like so much later can you finally have something to eat. It takes like hours. It is so, so long. But we have to wait a lot these days. We have to wait for school to start again, Sometimes school gets closed or our classes get closed because somebody is sick. We have to wait in lines. We have to wait for our birthdays and Christmas. We actually, when I think about it, we kind of do a whole lot of waiting, don't we? We wait a lot, you know? We spend so much time just waiting for something to happen. And sometimes it feels like it's gonna take forever for the thing to finally happen. So in today's story, we're gonna tell you about a guy named Simeon. And he had to wait a long time. I mean, like a long time. I mean, like a super long time. Like he had to wait a long, 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 long time for God to keep his promises to him. But you know what's cool? Is he didn't have to wait alone. Let's see what happened.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 25 through 35.
The birth of Jesus was unusual in many ways. He entered the world in a shelter with the animals and was celebrated by an entire host of angels.
Glory to God in the highest.
But Mary and Joseph cared for Jesus as with any child. When he was about 6 weeks old, they prepared to present him to the Lord at the temple.
The law says we must offer a sacrifice of two pigeons.
Or doves. How is he 6 weeks old already?
But as Mary and Joseph set out for Jerusalem with their firstborn son, someone was already waiting for them, a man named Simeon, and their stories were about to collide. Simeon had grown up in Jerusalem, faithfully worshiping God. He prayed daily.
Lord, help me understand your law. Help me serve you with my whole life.
Simeon would have studied the scriptures, words from the prophets from hundreds of years before.
The people who are now living in darkness will see a great light. They are now living in a very dark land, but a light will shine on them. What light, Lord?
Over the years, Simeon continued to pray, to worship, and to seek God in the temple. God's Holy Spirit was with him. And one day, the Spirit made Simeon a promise.
You will not die before you see the Lord's Messiah.
Me? With my own eyes? Thank you, Lord.
Simeon believed the promise and waited in joyful expectation.
Will it be today, Lord?
Simeon waited some more.
Will it be this year, Lord?
And then he waited still more.
How about this decade?
We aren't quite sure how long Simeon had to wait, but when his hair turned snow white, he was still waiting.
Soon, Lord.
Today, at last, Simeon received a new response.
The temple courtyard? I'm on my way. Where's my cloak? My walking stick?
God's Spirit led Simeon straight up to the Temple Mount and into the courtyard. Simeon stood in the center of the courtyard, allowing the voices to wash around him. He wasn't quite sure what he was looking for, but he knew God would reveal it to him.
A baby?
Simeon turned quickly to see a young couple nearby. The man carried a pair of doves in a small cage, the usual sacrifice after a child was born. The woman cradled a tiny baby in her arms.
Joseph, where do we go?
Excuse me.
Both the man and the woman looked up quickly.
May I hold the child?
Well, all right, yes.
Simeon took the child gently into his arms. In the eyes of this infant, he saw the face of God, the rescuer, God's promised Messiah.
His name is Jesus.
Overwhelmed, Simeon turned his gaze toward heaven.
Lord, you are the king over all. Now let me, your servant, go in peace. That is what you promised. My eyes have seen your salvation. You have prepared it in the sight of all nations, It is a light to be given to the Gentiles. It will be the glory of your people, Israel.
Mary and Joseph stared in amazement.
We knew he was special.
This.
Simeon looked down at the child, then glanced up at Mary and Joseph again.
May the Lord bless you both.
Gently, Simeon returned Jesus to his mother's arms. After a lifetime of waiting, Simeon was overjoyed to see the fulfillment of the promise God had given him so long ago.
Just checking, they're still not ready. See, we don't know how long Simeon had to wait before he got to see Jesus. It could have been weeks, it could have been months, it could have been years, it could have even been decades. Simeon had to wait a long, 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 long time for what God had promised him. But lucky for us, we don't usually have to wait years for something to happen. But the thing is, sometimes it can feel like it's taking years. Sometimes it feels like we've been waiting forever for something to happen. Especially when you're waiting for your birthday or for Christmas, then it feels like it's taking forever to come. Or when you're feeling sick and you're waiting to feel better, it can feel like it's taking forever to feel better again. I know it can be really hard to wait sometimes, but here's the good news. You don't have to wait alone. God is with you. He knows what you're going through. He knows what the whole world is going through. And he knows how it's all going to turn out. So this is what you can do. Number one, you can talk to God. Number two, you can put your trust in him. And number three, you can be sure that he will always be with you through absolutely everything. God will be there with you forever. So here's the one thing that you need to remember today. When you have to wait, remember God is with you. I'm still gonna have to wait for my biscuits to finish baking, although they smell really, 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 really good, I'm not gonna lie. But that's okay, because you know what? I'm not gonna be waiting alone. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much that even though we have to wait sometimes, and even though it feels like it's taking forever for things to change, or forever for things to get better, or forever for things to come, Lord, we know that you are always with us. Father God, you are with us forever, and no matter how much we have to wait, we never have to wait alone, because you are right there with us. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, guys, we've got two amazing crafts for you. We've got this decoder and this word search, and if you look in the description to this video, you'll find a link where you can print these out and complete them for yourself. But until next time, I'm gonna get back to my baking, and we're gonna see you all then. Bye!